Dexter Lawrence to remain suspended for Clemson's title game matchup with Alabama. Clemson's hope for having one of the nation's top defensive linemen available for the national championship game against Alabama have officially been extinguished. Christmas Eve, reports emerged that three Clemson football players, including star defensive tackle, had furosterine, a banned substance used to help increase muscle mass and strength, and would be suspended for the college football playoff semifinal game against Notre Dame. And, much to the chagrin of, although the university confirmed it would pursue an appeal of the ruling that would allow the linemen to play against the Crimson Tide. In a statement Thursday afternoon, athletic director confirmed that Lawrence, along with tight end and offensive linemen, will remain suspended and will not be available for Monday night's title game. The trio will, however, be permitted to travel with the team to California. Radakovich also noted that the university will continue the appeals process with the NCAA on behalf of the players. After winning the ACC Defensive Rookie of the Year award for the 2016 season, Lawrence has been a first-team All-Conference selection each of the past two seasons. Galloway, a true freshman, has caught 5 passes for 52 yards and a touchdown, while Giella, a redshirt junior, has played in 19 games during his time with the Tigers, including 8 this season. Now it appears we'll bring it. Not long after the reports of Fields potentially first surfaced, and before it was made official that his name, speculation had for the quarterback's transfer services. The connection between Fields and OSU, which is expected to lose starter to the NFL, at the start of the early signing period after Friday, and citing multiple sources, is reporting that Fields will be transferring to the Buckeyes. Another report has the quarterback already on the OSU campus, although it stops short of saying that the transfer has officially pulled the trigger on a move to the Buckeyes, even as it appears headed relatively quickly in that direction. Saw the report that former 5-star QB Justin Fields is transferring to. I can confirm that he is on the OSU campus there now. Would expect more details in the next 24 hours or so. Bruce Feldman, at Bruce Feldman, Fields, who had also considered Florida State and Oklahoma, had officially informed the Bulldogs of his intention to move on from UGA earlier this week. It's expected that, once Fields' move to OSU is official, he will seek a waiver that would grant him immediate eligibility. It's believed that Fields will use combined with T, immediate eligibility may be provided to a transfer student athlete, provided the transfer is due to mitigating circumstances that are outside the student athlete's control and directly impact the health, safety and well-being of the student athlete, to secure the ability to play in 2019. Fields has, the Arkansas-based lawyer who has become the go-to attorney for players in waiver cases, including Michigan's. Fields was rated by as the number one player regardless of position in the class of 2018. He spent his true freshman season as the primary backup to sophomore starter. S suspension cost the since-retired Ohio State head coach. The probe that led to the suspension, as it turned out, cost the university even more monetarily, not to mention what it did to its reputation nationally. In mid-August, it was reported that the law firm that was handling the investigation into Meyer, DeBevoise and Plimpton LLP, had been by the Office of Ohio Attorney General. Thursday, they reported, the investigation ended up costing the university $1 million. The AP writes that, OSU, spokesman Benjamin Johnson said Thursday the initial $500,000 was preliminary and didn't reflect the whole anticipated cost. According to the, a new request for $1 million to DeBevoise and Plimpton went before the controlling board in December and was approved, Ohio Attorney General's office spokesman Dan Tierney said. The entire $1 million fee was paid to the law firm late last month. Meyer was August 1st as questions into made against a now former assistant coach surfaced. The university into Meyer's actions, or inactions, as the case may be, the day after the head coach's leave was announced, with the university stating in an August 5th press release that the probe was expected to be completed from that date. Was his OSU wide receivers coach July 23rd in the wake of, during their marriage. Meyer was ultimately as a result of the investigation. In early December, Meyer announced that he would be retiring at the end of the 2018 season, a move that officially came to fruition with OSU's win over Washington in the Rose Bowl New Year's Day. The Virginia football family is mourning the loss of one of the program's most influential leaders. Friday, Virginia announced that passed peacefully in the presence of his family on Wednesday, January 2, in Charlottesville. Welsh was 85 years old and leaves behind 4 children. He was preceded in death by his wife of 52 years, Alexandra, in 2015. From 1982 to 2000, Welsh served as the Cavaliers' head football coach. His 134 wins are the most in school history, and he retired as the winningest coach in the history of ACC football. the Cavaliers won their only two ACC titles under Welsh, 1989-1995. The school's only 10-win season came during that 1989 campaign as well. They also achieved their first number one ranking the following season. I am saddened to hear that Coach Welsh passed away this week. My condolences go out to his family. He was a true pioneer for UVA football and provided the model of success we are working hard to replicate. We will miss his frequent visits to the football offices. Bronco Mendenhall, at UVA Coach Bronco, Welsh played his college football at Navy from 1952-55, where he was a first-team All-American quarterback as a senior. After serving as an assistant at Penn State for 10 years, 1963-72, the last seven of which was the head coach, Welsh returned to his alma mater as the midshipman's head coach. In nine seasons before he moved to Virginia, Welsh guided the Service Academy to a 55-46-1 record. In 2004, Welsh was voted into the College Football Hall of Fame. For the third and fourth times this cycle, Texas A&M has taken an early entry hit to its roster. Thursday evening, running back announced on Twitter that he will be foregoing his remaining eligibility in order to declare for the 2019 NFL Draft. A short time later on the same social media site, teammate and center announced the same decision. Williams' 1,760 yards this year, which included a 236-yard performance in, set a single-season school record, eclipsing the old standard of 1,692 yards set by in 1988. He finishes his Aggies career with 3,615 yards and 34 touchdowns. McCoy, who came to College Station as a two-star 2015 recruit, started every game each of the past three seasons for the Aggies. Williams and McCoy joined tight end and linebacker as Aggies who have declared early for the 2019 draft.